the first day for me was pretty cool because I've done a lot of flipped classrooms, but when Lodge came in, he really connected with chunking it more. I chunk it already like 5 minutes, but I'm probably going to go to a lot of that 1 minute chunk. And I loved how he asked for what's the big idea here and teaching kids how to synthesize that information and break it down and share it.
Love this because taking big bits of content, breaking it down into little chunks, letting the kids interact with it and bring it back and show what they've learned from that. Can't wait to use that. This is exactly what I was looking for.
This week I learned a lot about how I may be able to improve my efficiency. On the very first day, Dr. Lodge McCammon proved to me that I probably should be using video lectures a whole lot more. So that is what I'm going to be doing.
Making our teaching kinetic in mind and body. If you're not kinetic, then things just kind of atrophy. And plus, it gets kind of boring. So STEM is learning. STEM learning energizes. So follow the doctor's advice, make your learning kinetic.
The thing I took away the most was it came down to the flipped classroom. This graph blew my mind, and I'm really excited to take this back when it comes down to looking at really how we teach and direct instruction versus actually flipping the classroom and having a video and giving students a chance to take ownership of it so we can work efficiently and really stop wasting their time and ours when it comes to working in our classroom.
From day one, I just got a new way of looking at the flipped classroom, videotaping a presentation and showing it to start a class, give students more time for actual activity, also increase student engagement, and then cut down on the teacher fatigue.
I chose to record my Pachacucha presentation to get over my fear of videos, which is what I really took from day number one. This will help me to flip my classroom and to review my teaching on a regular basis.
I really was just blown away by Lodge and just really thinking about redefining what we're accountable for and making our lessons shorter by using videos. So I'm like really, really charged up about that. And I love the idea of bringing in music and dance. I try to use it in a lot of ways, but this gave me some really great ideas. So.
Building a classroom, any classroom, the STEM classroom, a history classroom, it's about connecting, making those connections between math and dance and facts and movements and music and science.
So we're up and dancing and out of our comfort zone, and already everyone's like, okay, I see how I can do this. And it really got us going early, which was awesome.
I want an experience that's exciting, that's flipped, that's joyous, that's challenging.
I've been making my own now that look like this. A lot different, a lot quicker, a lot more, but they're even going to be better after this experience now.
The very first day I got in here and I didn't really know if I belonged here. I didn't know if I had what it takes, but Lodge really made me see that I'm doing the right things in my classroom. I do a flipped classroom, but he also showed me a different way of doing that flipped classroom. So it showed me that I'm doing great things, but I also have a lot more to learn, and I'm totally open to that.
I was so pleased to have aha moments right from the start. As a video education teacher, I have felt that I should be flipping my classroom for a long time, but in a mixed demographic, I really didn't feel like I could hold my students accountable for that. But Lodge solved that obstacle by showing me that I could do video in the classroom. And I am looking forward to a long-standing goal of having myself and students create video in the classroom and allowing more time for hands-on exploration.
So transparency, to use the science word, it means so that something that allows you to see things clearly. It's not translucent, it's not opaque, it allows you to see things clearly. And that's what Dr. Lodge started me thinking about, is how to flip your classroom to make yourself transparent to your people.
So the first thing I really looked at and learned, of course, as many of you did, was how efficient the flipped classroom can be. And so I want to not only flip by, you know, making my own videos, but I want to challenge some of my students to make videos as well, so they're not just seeing me, they're seeing each other.